ever out of the spotlight. With her ups and her downs.
Some guy said, I've been to Pete's one.
Good for you.
I just don't want to be used, basically.
She's the most talked about woman in Britain. But this is the real story of what Katie did next.
Piss up.
This week, with Christmas over, she's looking forward to the future. With a new look.
I doubt I'll get caned for having these put in.
Love it.
And a New Year's Eve party to remember.
I love it.
Mummy, it's a pumpkin.
Yeah, it looks ridiculous.
This is going to be the best party to be at tonight.
Don't ever with me.
My smoke alarm's going off. Oh, shit.
But can she escape the past?
I hate 2009. I hate it. I hate it.
For Katie, Christmas 2009 wasn't quite what she'd planned.
It's the worst Christmas I've ever had, to be honest.
Junior and Princess were with Pete until 6 p.m. on Christmas Day, which meant that Katie and Harvey were home alone.
No one can ever take Harvey away from me, ever.
So today, Boxing Day, along with Mum Amy and Stepdad Paul, Katie's family celebrations can begin. With no camera crew around, Katie agreed to film it for posterity.
This is my Christmas Day and I'm filming myself. And this is Harvey, so not interested in presents. He's more interested in that. That. Harvey, I think you've had enough. Don't you? With candy canes. That is Granddad Paul and Junior open presents for my mum, dad and Soph. And as you can see, Princess has tried to put makeup on. Princess, what have you got? Holly, that will be on your own. Do it again.
It's the next day, and with Christmas now behind her, Katie's determined to get the new year off to a spectacular start. So she's throwing a huge fairy tale themed party, which she's organising herself.
I'm doing my list for my New Year's Eve party. Because I've texted everyone, so I've got to tick off who's coming and who's not. I just put so far, hi, I'm having an enchanted fancy dress party at home New Year's Eve. My house is turning into Narnia. I have catering, entertainment, fireworks, etc. Please let me know ASAP if you can come for catering and drink purposes. And this is my list of people I've invited so far. All of them. So I actually do know some people.
On Katie's list, there's a whole host of famous faces, including her ex, Dane Bowers.
Oh, no, you don't mess about. Oh, this is Dane, because I was going to meet him today to go for some music ideas. And because he's coming New Year's Eve. I said, I can't meet because the set designers are coming. He put, laugh out loud, set designers, you don't mess about, do you? Sounds like it's going to be a good night. Be good to see you and finally have a drink. No, it's not, Dane, because you know I'm a nightmare. Right, there's so many people confirmed so far. 37, 38, 39, 40. 40 people so far confirmed. Here's it going. Yeah, 40 people have confirmed. But little do I know, there are plus ones and I haven't met them, so really only 20 have confirmed out of my 90. You've got to laugh now, mates. No, they will get back to me, honest.
As well as sorting the guests for her party, Katie's also after a new look, but it's not going to be a natural one.
I'm not happy with a boob job. I'm not happy with Botox. I'm not happy with hair extensions. I now have to have eyelash extensions. I'll be real one day. There'll be a time in my life that maybe I could never afford to have all this. Then you'll see the real ugly me, the real ugly sister. Can you believe? They say never wear white. I was eating a bagel. I thought, oh, what the hell's this feeling? I spilt it all down me.
So, a day of pampering begins. First up, eyelash extensions.
The last time I had them was 8 years ago, when I was pregnant with Harvey. Why not try to be a bit more glam?
Come for you.
Excuse my dirty trousers. I've just bought bagels.
Come for you. Take a seat.
When I used to live down here, I used to come here, and it was back, Harvey's seven, so I was pregnant about 8 years ago. I think they must have sort of first come out. I had them done here. Oh, yes. Let's have a look at them.
These are the longest and the thickest ones that we do, but obviously.
Do you know, I'm not going to do it, but I'd love to just go.
Yeah.
They do look like you.
You've got the fan on there, actually. I don't want to turn that off.
Oh, really? So they're the longest and the thickest? Now, this isn't a quick job, ladies and gentlemen. No. It takes about an hour and a half to do.
Yeah, maybe a bit more.
Really? Night. How many did you put in at a time? One?
Yes.
Oh, God, no wonder it takes so long.
Normally put in between 60 and 80, or as many as we possibly can.
I was going to say, 60 and 80, I want double.
It doesn't sound a lot, but we will be putting lots in.
Like my hair extensions, I've got enough of my hair for three people. I know I probably didn't need these, really.
No, but
it I like them.
All it will do is, you know, it will just make them look, volume-wise, a lot thicker. By just having some extra ones, I'll just keep
going until you reckon there's loads.
Well, I think there's loads on now, but you know, obviously, you like yours really
full.
Yeah.
For Katie, looks are all important, and having been in the modelling industry for 15 years, she's well aware of the pressures on women to keep their youthful appearance.
I think it's always nice for women to be immaculate, but there's a time where a woman can start to look mutton. And I think you sort of know that. But some women still cross it and do it. And at the end of the day, there's no right or wrong to do anything. It's how you feel and what you want to do. There's people now, well, I don't like some people's dress sense, they don't like mine. But that's what makes you individual. You do whatever you want to do. Because it's like some people who are mutton, they go out dressed up thinking people are looking at them, thinking that they look great, when really they're thinking, what the hell have you got on? There's a difference, and I've got enough people around me to tell me if I'm mutton or not. Doesn't matter how much surgery you have. I think when you get a lot older, if you have too much surgery, you look stupid. Because you look like you're old, trying to look young. But things like this, having your eyebrows tinted, having your eyelashes done, it's non-surgical and it makes a big difference.
Makes you feel good.
So I don't care what anyone said. You know, you colour your hair, that makes a difference. There's lots of ways you can make yourself look better, which is non-surgical. Believe me, I can afford surgery. So there's lots I could have done if I really wanted to, and I don't. But no doubt I'd get caned for having these put in.
Oh, I think they look great.
Yeah, I don't care what anyone says. It's no different to wearing false eyelashes, is it?
No, it's exactly the same.
I don't want to be natural. Boring. And look at me, I've got a big house, big car, big boobs. Big hair, big lashes, big horses. Anything I can have larger than life, I do.
Over 200 new lashes later, all individually glued on.
Yeah, I love it.
The operation is complete.
I love it.
Oh,
Oh, my eyes. I'm going to the car now. I'll see you at Julie's.
Not content with just the one session of party pampering, Katie's off for another couple of hours to friend Julie's beauty salon.
That's new. I think you might quite like that. That's nice. Or you could go slut red. For a change. Why can't you go something like that? That'd be really trendy for you.
Julie's one of Katie's oldest friends and always on hand to give her advice.
Have you got that in a pink of some sort?
That is a pink, love.
That's a red, love.
It's a pink, that, love.
That is pink.
Don't start, pink, love.
Is it?
That's a red, love.
What do you reckon? That or that?
Well, it'd be that. Nice to see in something different and bang on trend.
I'll go that then, yeah?
She needs telling at times because she thinks she knows better and she doesn't always know best.
If you give me some thingy.
Julie does.
With the nail sorted, Julie's treating Katie to a chill-out body massage, and the fairy tale fancy dress New Year's Eve party is the main topic of conversation.
Why can't you have a black, you know, like a black dress party?
Because that's boring.
Like diamonds and tiaras or something. Why have we got to dress up like a princess?
Well, you could dress up as an apple, like me.
An apple? What do I want to be an apple for?
Well, I'm making the effort to put it on so people can make an effort to come.
I mean, can you imagine me in a tutu?
In an apple.
Tutu, fairy. I bet you were a fairy. I bet you wear a tutu.
I bet Gary and Phil do.
Yeah, probably. I bet your house is going to be so hot. The less clothes, the better, really.
Of course. It'd be amazing. Got a DJ. I've got him from the X Factor after party, played wicked music. I'm going to have karaoke.
Oh, God. Will you be singing any ballads?
I'll be singing more ballads than you can ever. You've had hot dinners in your life.
Oh, God, no.
In fact, I bought an audition book.
Oh, no.
Imagine.
Not only is she the star of the night, she's the star of the entertainment.
Who's doing the food and that? You're going to get the food all done.
Got catering coming. It's proper. So I'm messing about.
I don't know about my flip-flops, that's my dressing gown.
She's escaped from the asylum, she really looks like it.
Bothered?
I hope no one sees me that knows me.
No one bloody sees me.
So that's a whole day's pampering taken care of, but not much preparation for the party, and there's still a lot more to do. Still to come, Junior's horsing around.
You love Mooney.
No, he's my pony.
And Katie's trying out another new look.
Look, Junior, Mummy is a pumpkin.
Katie's looking forward to the year ahead and spending more time with her kids. Having bought Junior his very own horse for Christmas, she's taking him and Princess off to the local stables to play with his new toy. But not before the kids have a little game of their own.
Shall we hide for Mummy?
Today's trip might be all fun and games for the kids, but for Katie, horse riding is a lifelong obsession.
My mum bought me my first horse when I was 15, and I bought my first horse when I was about 18. All I know is that I loved horses from the first time I sat on one. So, I've always loved him.
I saw your horsey, Mummy.
Mooney, you tell him, who is that, Junior?
Mooney.
It's your pony, isn't he?
Yeah.
Right, in you get then.
I love the Mooney.
You love love Mooney.
No, he's my pony. And you don't love him. I do.
Because he likes to get on my horses and sees me ride, then I'll encourage him to ride. And the moment he says he doesn't like it, then I wouldn't force him to do it. I don't agree with parents pushing kids to do anything. That's not the way forward. You want your kid to enjoy it.
So Mooney's all saddled up and ready to go. But he's not the only one under pressure to look the part. With just 2 days to go before the new year, time is running out for Katie's friends to get ready for her big fairy tale theme bash. With her strict fancy dress on no entry policy, everyone's making an effort, including friend Gary and publicist Diana. Katie's meeting them later on, but until then, there are some costume choices to be made.
Not quite sure what I want to go as, but I think it's probably going to be in the Prince Charming-esque sort of mode. So, a red Indian. Pearly Queen. Nah, don't know if I'll get in that. I don't even think I'll get my leg in that.
Razzle dazzle.
You have, like, a black dress underneath.
Oh, I should have done this. This is very me.
At the Copa, Copacabana, Cabana.
Anne Boleyn.
What's that? American footballer? It's not really me, is it?
This is my mate Lucas.
Hello.
And he's going to go to the party, and I'm not quite sure what he's going to go as, but I think he'll probably be in that vein.
That's far too much for me. I think I'm going to go as the evil Snow Queen instead.
The shop is filling up with Katie's friends gearing up for the big do. And in one of the changing rooms is former blues singer Duncan James.
How's it going?
This is Duncan.
Hello. Getting ready for Katie's party.
I think we're all doing the same thing, aren't we?
I know.
Do you know what? I thought at first I was going to do like Aladdin or something, but I just love these Prince Charming costumes.
They're kind of cool, aren't they?
But it's not going to look like that on me, is it?
Of course it will. What you got? What you think? Oh God, look at the hat.
Oh, that's brilliant.
I love that.
Oh, that is absolutely brilliant. Does it go that way? I wouldn't need a wig with that, then, would I?
You wouldn't need a wig. You'd be very hot. But
it's always good for when you say.
Oh, God, that's a bit much. That is.
Hang on, I haven't finished it yet.
No, I love it. It's a bit Quentin Crisp.
It is.
This one. Yes, I am dressed.
Oh my God.
Katie's brief was like Narnia, Disney, fairy tale, and
carry on. No, it's all right.
To be honest, it's like, what do you go? Do you go with something like you can go like a lion or something from Narnia, or you go as like something from like Aladdin, or you can go as like a Prince Charming. We had a big old discussion about it, didn't we, beforehand?
Yeah.
And we came up with like some kind of Prince Charming outfit, but
that couldn't be anything but a Prince Charming.
That's what he said. He said I had to be a Prince Charming.
Oh, that looks cool. I like that. This is sort of getting in the Prince Charming mode, isn't it? What do they used to do? Prince Charming, Prince Charming, ridicule is nothing to be scared of. But there's just so much stuff. I mean, look at this. We are in Aladdin's cave.
I'm loving that.
This is what I'm
That's
wearing.
That's really cool. This is a better hat, isn't it? Better hat? Lessons takes the campness down a little bit by being blue.
Maybe. I don't know though, because I did like the. I just like that other one because it's just so over the top.
It's time for Junior to take the reins and show off his riding skills.
Right, what do you do? My princess, you stand there. Right, what do you do to make him move forward? Sit.
Good boy.
Spending some quality time with her son has given Katie a chance to bond with him over their new shared interest.
I'm looking forward to 2010. Hopefully I'll be competing a lot on my horses. I hope to take the kids to shows on the horses and everything else can follow. Right, make him walk on. Good kick. Right, stop him then. Set. Take both feet out. Set, hold on to there. And swing your leg round. That's it. Whee!
He may not be Olympic standard just yet, but it's been a successful day's riding for Junior.
Hi, Mooney!
And his new steed. Gary's looking the part, but he's turning his attention to Katie's outfit, and he's got some concerns.
Kate was saying to me, I don't want to do the obvious thing. I don't want to be like a snow queen, a fairy or whatever, or a damsel in distress or whatever, Snow White. She said, I want to do something different. But her idea of different is like a gingerbread man or an apple. I'm like, you can't come as a gingerbread man or an apple. It's your party. But I don't know. She probably will.
Do you reckon it's better than the other one?
Yeah, because I think the other one was too. Okay. It was like you were wearing this colour everywhere. It was too skin tone.
Does it work with a black waistcoat?
Definitely.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. With the do you know what? Yeah, that's good.
See, now you don't even need a button.
Hello. I just need a beauty spot.
So that's Duncan, or rather Prince Charming, sorted. The time's moving on. So, in an attempt to steer Katie away from some of her more outlandish ideas, Gary's selecting a few more traditional outfits ready for her arrival. And he's taking his job very seriously.
She needs something. She still wants to look sexy. I think she should do Dorothy. Or, oh, I don't know. Or Frankenfurter. Or Queen Elizabeth I. See, I love that. I mean, do you know what she should do? No, seriously, she should be Queen Elizabeth I and just do that whole Queen thing. Do you not think?
Downstairs, Katie's appeared with boyfriend Alex and Junior.
Hello. Hey, look at you.
Hi, Junior.
How are you?
Katie and Alex are still keeping their relationship under wraps, so this is a rare public outing.
You look, you'd be beautiful if you was a girl. Look at him, Jenny, look.
Can I lick him?
But you're beautiful as a boy.
Over there, go and have a look.
It's nothing to do with me. It's not
it's nothing to do with Alex. He's never seen Alex dressed like that. And he never will.
What do you think?
I love it. I absolutely, don't you love it?
Yeah.
Not with the black tights.
No, not with the black tights.
What outfit have you got? You've got a choice of two. Which ones is it? What you're going to wear to the fancy dress party?
I'm going to wear Buzz Lightyear.
Or?
Woody.
And which one do you want to wear?
Buzz Lightyear.
OK, you wear that one then.
Mummy, why are your parties not today?
It's in 2 nights, 2 more sleeps. Then it's a big party. Okay.
Is it tomorrow?
No, 2 nights. And there's going to be lots and lots and lots of people coming into our house.
How many?
Over 100.
About 1,000?
No, I don't know 1,000 people.
Alex is getting straight down to business.
Well, can you try on?
What do you think of this costume, Junior? Better.
No, that one.
You're going to try this one?
Do you want me, shall I bring one up so you can have a look at it?
These? Basically, I don't want to wear much clothes because I've got a good body.
You don't have
to wear...
It's
going to be a hot house.
Come down with me now.
Even though Gary's lined up a whole host of beautiful costumes, Katie's after some other ideas.
What have you got that's really the most over-the-top outfit in here?
One pumpkin.
Yes! I love it! That is wicked! Look at that, Junior! Mummy is a pumpkin! Wicked! He's got an all-in-one orange suit that goes underneath. Do you know, I wore a pumpkin outfit. I had a New Year's Eve party. The year I met Pete, it was before I went in the jungle, I had one. I was a pumpkin then, but it wasn't as good as this. This is proper.
It's a popular costume, especially at Halloween, as you can imagine.
I think it's wicked. I'm going to try on with the hat properly. And like that, people would expect me to go in like, a little suspender outfit.
Yeah.
I don't want to do that. I want to be the opposite.
So, Katie's going to a fairy tale theme bash as a pumpkin. And along with her outfit, there's a very intriguing party guest list too.
I brought Alex along as well, because obviously he's coming, because he's going into Big Brother on Sunday. And also my ex Dane Bowers is coming. So it'll all meet.
Not happy with his Zorro outfit, Alex has been browsing. But one of his suggestions isn't so popular with Katie.
This is as close to a Greek god as I got. I thought you looked quite cool.
So, yes. Yeah. You can't come as a Greek god.
Why?
Please, right, not on Anuja. Stay away from the Greeks, please.
With the Greek option out of the question, Alex is trying out something a bit closer to home.
They're so little. I love He-Man. I grew up on He-Man. He was the best. He-Man. Oh, is it broken? No, you broke it.
Determined to be the absolute belle of the ball, Katie's decided that just the one outfit won't be enough.
Cruella de Vil. Oh, I like that. No, I really like that. That's, yeah.
Why do you like that?
Oh, you look wicked.
You're Cruella de Vil.
The ones you've got cigarette lighter.
I love you, Snow White.
With closing time fast approaching, there are decisions to be made.
Is that boring?
Good. I prefer the other one.
Do you not want to be a fairy or...?
So many fairies.
Do I like that?
That looks good now.
Yeah, that's so much better.
Yeah.
It's not a lot... Yeah, it's not a lot of clothes as well, so I like that as well.
No, that looks good.
Yeah, that's the one.
That looks wicked, doesn't it?
I think that's so much better.
Yeah, it looks ridiculous.
I'll take that as well.
That's my favourite.
Yeah?
It's going to be a good night. I can be either Zeus, Alexander the Great, a Roman god, a Greek god. So, yeah, it's all good.
Alex the Great may be sorted, and it looks like Katie's nailed it too.
So, I'm going for three outfits. I'm starting off with the pumpkin, then a bit of Cruella de Vil, and then Minnie Mouse.
Still to come, preparations take over Pricey's palace.
Kate is not here. And we need her.
And Katie gets into character. It's early morning on New Year's Eve, the day of Katie's fairy tale fancy dress party. And Katie's out buying supplies.
I'm now going to go get some orange juice for tonight. Lots of orange juice, lemon juice and apple juice. And you can see what I come back with. Yep.
Meanwhile, her house is buzzing with activity. She's employed the services of an event design company, and at the helm is creative director Toby Roberts.
Just cut it down, cut these bits off, and just stuff it so it holds the mirror tree in place.
Along with a few other willing participants, Katie's charged them with the task of transforming her house into an enchanted winter wonderland party venue.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I've brought me some corn for popping.
Katie's drafted in best friend and makeup artist Gary as a sort of project manager.
Let it snow. Can I just get here? Yes. Yeah, that bar's there. Once I finish it off, we'll go right in the front here.
As well as all the winter wonderments, there's also the small matter of turning Katie's cinema room into a full-on dance floor. That job's fallen to Katie's friend and makeover expert, Phil.
It's the dance floor. It doesn't look much at the moment. But a bit of fake snow on there, all the way over it. The only thing I'm worried about is women with high heels, and obviously maybe men with high heels tonight, because I'm sure there'll be quite a few of those. Anyway, here we go.
As Phil marches on, Gary's concerned that one fairly crucial member of the team is still out shopping.
Kate is not here. That is the point. And we need her. We need all the hands we can get, because as you can see, this has got to be transformed into a winter wonderland.
So.
With or without Katie, there's lots to be done and very little time.
The conservatory?
Yes.
What are you doing in there?
We're just putting two white flutes in there, that's it.
Right, so what would you like the cleaners to do?
They can just clean.
A bit like me, not very straight. This is literally hardboard to protect the carpet. How many people we've got? 100, 120? Lots of drinks, food. You'd never get it out, would you, so?
The hostess is on her way home to see the transformation.
It's all going to be done for me. I haven't really got anything to stress about, but you still stress because, oh, my God, I've got to write down the names yet for the guy on the door to let people in. That's what I do have to do. I'll be celebrating a bloody good new year to come. Get rid of it. I've decided the number 9 is my unlucky number. Just a question, I don't know, but was Dwight York's number on his shirt number 9? Really? I thought it was. There you go, I told you number 9's bad luck. September, is that the 9th month?
Yep.
And I got married in September, the 9th month. It just goes to show that number 9 is definitely my unlucky number.
Back at the house, Katie's ever-growing army of workers struggle to get everything finished on time.
This is over.
It's rubbish.
The time I spend on my knees is ridiculous.
Even Princess is joining in as Mummy's cast-offs are cleared away to make room for Katie's winter wonderland.
I think she's got more clothes here than most people have in 2 lifetimes.
Quick, I'm here. Done.
Right, I wonder who's going to be at the house now. Will the caterers be there yet? The DJs? Will the house be done? Kids be moaning? Do I go and have a lie down? I might run a bath, put some oils in it, have a little lie down. Ready for action. I might surprise everyone tonight and not actually get drunk.
With only a few hours to go, the house has finally started to take shape.
Shut these as well. Hello, Harvey. It's... What's all this? Is it like Christmas?
Mummy
works
on
Tuesdays. You're not having food,
I'm
just eating. Wait. Go.
I'm having
good. Go on in, go. Well, that looks good, doesn't it? So, Toby, he's done me a massive, massive favour for New Year's.
Mirror trees.
And I said sort of like Narnia kind of, and this is exactly right.
Winter Wonderland, we wanted to really give it. We wanted big glitter twigs. Yeah. We wanted snowy effects. We wanted disco, because obviously it's New Year's Eve. We wanted a bit of mirrors. You know, lots of silver and white. And
done it, brilliant. And in now, I can't believe you transformed my room into like...
we're in the middle of doing that, and it's before we finish, all of these will be in there with white lights and snow.
Brilliant, I can't believe that. It's brilliant.
It's going to be great.
I can't wait. And obviously, when it gets dark, we dim the lights a bit.
Dim the lights, and you'll just have a bit more sparkly,
yeah.
Shining around, I'll be all mirrory and disco-y.
I can't wait.
Hot on her heels, Katie's order of soft drinks has arrived, along with yet more helpers.
Hey, how are you? Good to see you.
You too, you're
right.
Like DJ Frank, who got the gig after Katie heard him play at a recent X Factor party she attended. But tonight, she's planning to realise some of her own singing ambitions on his karaoke machine.
Can we have a little
yeah.
Melody, oh, no one's here to play with me. Gary! Come and hear it with me.
What is that?
Come and hear it with me, the sound.
Oh my God, I'm gonna be on it all night.
All night. All night long. Tonight. You know it.
It's been a gargantuan task. The team have worked tirelessly all day, and finally, Katie's dream fairy tale party venue has been created. Junie has been transformed into Buzz Lightyear, and Princess has been transformed into, well, a princess. All that's left now is for Katie to transform herself, with a bit of help, of course.
Do you know, the good thing about me is my best friends, one's my hairdresser and best friend, one's my makeup artist, and guess what? Tonight I haven't asked her to do my hair and Gary hasn't done my makeup. But I've asked Abby to do my nails.
Yeah.
Oh, so my makeup look all right, I've only, because I had the extension lashes, I've done foundation and eyebrows and blush. I want smoky eyes. Do you reckon I need it or not?
What?
No, it's where your eyelashes come off. It looks all dark there anyway.
The party's not even started, but ready or not, more and more people keep coming through the doors.
You should have done.
That was my... It was Tigers and Hercules, but I don't look
good in
Greece.
We're going as Adam
and
Eve.
So I'm going to go...
We've only got two leaves.
Yeah, that's right. All right, thank you. Anyway,
Is this house has turned into a fucking changing room? That's not good, is it? People should turn up dressed up, surely.
And what the frig is that, then?
You look wicked. Did she look good? I need someone to do me up. Oh, my God. The party is in 45 minutes and people are bound to come earlier. I'm shitting it now.
Still to come, the party really hots up.
My smoke alarm's going off.
And Katie boils over. It's 7 p.m. on New Year's Eve and Katie's big fancy dress bash is about to begin. The first of the 90 guests who are going to help boyfriend Alex and Katie say goodbye to a traumatic 2009 are trickling in.
Hi.
Junior and Princess are among the first to start limbering up on the dance floor, while Mum Katie's lumbering around in the first of her three outfits of the night, a pumpkin.
Well, I'm in the outfit. I'm very hot. Party started, I don't know who's here. Don't know half of them already.
But best friends are on the way. Enter a rather dashing Gary. And Prince Phil. Party's really getting started and Katie's winter wonderland is being invaded with fairies, Spider-Man, Tinkerbells, pirates, Mad Hatters, a sort of pink flamingo, a king, a wicked witch of the west.
Is it because I was queen?
Captain Hook. And a few princes. Or should that be princesses?
This is the fairy princess.
Fairy prince. Fairy prince.
What a beautiful princess this is.
Wicked. Put on your makeup, Gary, or you?
Okay, of course.
Oh, really, Gary? You done his makeup, though?
You probably did.
Gary's done his makeup, but look at me, Mrs. Natural.
While Katie's purpose-built dance floor is being put to good use, she's heading out for a quick break.
Get out!
But as usual, in Katie's world, the drama's never far away.
My smoke alarm's going off. Shit, the fire brigade are gonna come.
Bonkers.
Oh, no! The fire brigade!
No.
Oh.
Please,
I'm stuck!
It's been only half
fire brigade are going to turn up.
Oh shit! Greg, the manager of the house, the smoke alarm's going off. The fire brigade's on their way. Can you please turn the alarm off?
Bonkers.
Thank you. Turn it off.
Fire alarm crisis over, and Katie's found time to change into outfit number two.
Cruella de Vil, baby, don't ever fuck with me. Ever, baby. Don't ever fuck with me.
With the party in full swing, model Danielle Lloyd puts in an appearance, along with singer Simon Webb.
We're just having a 5-minute breather. And then we're going to rock and roll. Yeah. Huh? Everybody is dressed up. They look fabulous. I think we're in for a good party.
Suck it in.
I mean, this is going to go on, I would imagine, all night. Yeah, and it'll be absolutely great.
Hello, Happy New Year.
Oh, you're so gorgeous.
As 2010 draws nearer, things are starting to get lively. And, of course, there's been another costume change.
Right. Flash.
Minnie Mouse has bagged her Hercules boyfriend Alex. With the countdown about to start, the guests head to the dance floor. It's an ideal opportunity for Katie to put the karaoke machine to good use. Midnight just minutes away, there's no stopping her as Katie gets ready to usher in 2010. Looking back on 2009, there's not been an awful lot for Katie to celebrate. She's been front page news for all the wrong reasons, with a very public split with Pete, resulting in divorce, going into the jungle and being challenged by the public, and breaking up with Alex on live TV. All in all, 2009 is probably a year that Katie would rather forget. For Katie, hopefully a new beginning. Next week.
This is like Dynasty in Dallas.
This is like hell.
It's life without Alex.
I'm missing cuddles, I'm missing love, I'm missing kisses.
But a snow in.
We're all snowed in. Oh, you'll get it out now.
Whips up a media storm.
No one even knows I stayed at your house.
Messing with the wrong girl here.
There's more from Katie at 9 next Thursday here on ITV2. Next tonight, pretending to be a Bond girl looks like fun for Belle in Secret Diary of a Cool Girl. And don't forget, there's more American Idol at 10:30.